Yes.
Web services.
Yeah, we started with web services. So what is the main use of doing for web services?
Exchanging the data between applications.
Right. Exchange of data from one application to other application. Interacting from one application to other application. Okay. And one more word important. Why we go for web services? Hello, Jyoti.
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, so what is the need of going for web services? What type of applications we can develop using web services?
Distributed.
Right.
Distributed.
That is very, very important. Distributed. It is used to develop distributed applications, which are, or you can say simple, interoperable distributed applications means language independent. When you want to go for language independent distributed means there is only one solution in Java, that is web services. Got it?
Yes.
And we have seen one example yesterday, like how to create a web service using access tool, and you should follow every step properly. If you miss out one step, then it goes with errors. Okay, so what you have done? We have created a project, and while creating the project, access to configure your access tool. Okay, and we have created a class. We have created a class and we made this class as web service. Okay, so once you make it as web service, it will generate a VSTL file, right? Once you deploy the application, it will generate the VSTL file. That VSTL file we use while developing the client program. Okay, so let us go with one more example today to feel comfortable of SOAP web services. So let us go with one more example. For this one, create a class account in com.ws project of my first website. Can mute yourself, please. Upon dot java. So this class we want to make it as web service. So create this class. So you can go to this com.ws package in which you can find in Java resources src folder. Right click on package into new class. The class which you want to make it as web service. So create a class here. Account. Then I'm going with some methods inside this. I'm going with one static data member. Balance equal to some 50%. We are going with the two methods here, public void deposit. Deposit which takes amount as an argument. And when you go for deposit, what is the operation we need to do? Balance equal to balance plus amount, right everyone?
Yeah.
We are going with one more method, public void withdraw, which takes amount. And here the operation is balance equal to balance minus amount. Okay, I'm not going for the checking whether the balance is, whether the amount is less than balance, all those things. Okay, just I'm going with some methods here. Public int get balance. When you call the method get balance, it will return the balance. Okay, so in this account class, I'm going with the three methods. So clear with this class, all of you.
Yeah.
Right. Now we want to make this class as web service. Okay, so that this class can be used in some other applications. Okay, so how to make this one as web service? So what we are, what is our next step? Create account class as web service. So how to make it as a web service? What we have to do? Click on File, New, and you can find Other. In Other, go to Web Services. Under that, you can find Web Service. Say Next. Same steps. Okay, so service implementation, we have to select the account class. Okay, so how to do this? Click on File, New, Other, under Web Services, you can find Web Service. So in service implementation, so which class we need to select? com.ws.account. Okay, so since up to now we are having two classes, so if you click on drop down, you can find one more class. Got it, everyone? If you are in so many classes, click on browse and select. Okay,
yeah.
So once you select the account class, then under configuration, click server runtime. Under configuration, server runtime. Okay. Once you click here, under Web Service Runtime, we have to select Access To. Under Web Service Runtime, Access To select. Okay. So once you select, click on OK. Once you click on OK, then click on Next button. Click on Next button. Then click on Start Server. Click Next. Next. Click on Start Server. That's it. Click on Finish. So once the server is started, click on Finish button. Click on Finish button. Okay, that's it. Then once you click on Finish button, your web service is ready to use. And how to see the list of services? What is it? http://localhost/my-first-web-service/services/list-services. What is our next step? Open the following URL to see the list of services available. Okay, so this is a list of services. So in this one, you can see account. You can find one more first web service. So when you go for account, what are the available operations here? Get balance, deposit, and withdraw. Got it, everyone? Right,
yeah.
Clear up to you? Right. So how to know how to get a Vistel file? If you click on account. Click on the link account to get the Vistel URL. Okay, so this is the Vistel URL. See, the element name deposit will become an element and the argument will become sub-element. Similarly for withdraw and also get balance. Okay, these are the three methods here. So, click on account link to get the Vistel URL. Okay, then what we have to do? Copy the Vistel URL. What is that in our case? Copy the Vistel URL. Clear up to you? copy this Vistel URL. So once you copy this Vistel URL, what we have to do with this Vistel URL? To generate the client program, right? It is used for what? Writing the client program. Okay, so let us go with the client program. Creating web service client for account web service. How to go for web service client?
Create web service client.
Right, again, click on file. Click on file, new, other. Under other, you can find web service. Under that, web service client. Under that, web service client. See here. Click on file, new, other, under web services, you can find web service client, select here and say next. Then in service definition, paste the Vistel URL. Okay. In service definition, paste the Vistel URL. Okay. Then what is the next step? Click on server runtime. Click on server runtime. Select access to. Click next. Let me show. Click on server runtime, select access to and say OK. Click next and say finish, which will generate stubs for us. So by using that stub, we are going to write the client program. Okay, so which will generate here account stub. I can see here account stub.java. By using this, we are going to write the client program. So what is our next step? Creating test class or client test class account test. Account test in com.ws package. Wherever you want, you can create it. Account test dot job. This is the one which we need to do. Right click on com.ws, the new class. Account test with main method. So how to start writing the client program? You remember yesterday I've mentioned. So we have to create object of stub first. Okay, so like account stub equal to new account stub. Okay, then once you create object of account stuff, then what is the methods will become as classes in your client program, right?
Yes.
So which are the methods here? Deposit, withdraw and get balance. So those will become classes here. So let me go with the deposit operation. So deposit equal to new deposit. And deposit method is going with how many arguments?
One
argument. What is that? Amount, right? So yeah. The argument will become as properties in your deposit class, right? Letter method. So we have to set them. Deposit dot set amount. The amount which you want to deposit, we have to give that value. So deposit dot set amount, and we pass some amount like 40,000. We want to go for deposit of 40,000. Then now, once we set the amount, now by using the stub, we have to call the actual method. So to call the actual method, stub dot deposit, and to that deposit method we have to pass where deposit object. Got it? Okay. If you are getting confused, I'll select this. DEP. Okay. So what we are doing, we are creating deposit object, and to the by using stuff, we have to call the actual method, and to that one, we have to pass the deposit object. Clear up to here?
Yes.
Okay. So now the deposit operation will happen now. It will execute the deposit method with the 40,000 as amount. Then, now in order to know the balance amount, in order to get the balance amount, so we are having a method get balance. So that will become a class here. Get balance, balance equal to new get balance. Then now we have to call the get balance method. How to call get balance method? By using struct dot get balance. So that pass your balance. This output I want to store it in some variable. So you want to get the value means you have to use the method get balance response. So when you are having some value to be written, we have to use the class get balance response. Response equal to struct dot get balance. Then to take the value of it, you can say sysout current balance equal to res dot get return. That's it. When you call the method get return, it returns the value of your application. That is the value what you get from this get balance. Now when you run the program, what is the balance now? What is the balance? I've given initial balance as 50,000, right?
Yeah.
And when you deposit 40, now the balance should be 90,000. See, run the program. So we get the current balance as 90,000. Clear? Hema Bindu?
Yeah.
Jyoti Monica?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Swati Vinila?
Yeah.
Now let us go for the next operation, withdraw. I'm keeping this code in the comments. So withdraw. So what I need to do? We have to create object of withdraw equal to new withdraw. Then go for what? Withdraw dot set amount. So I want to withdraw something like 20,000. If we want to withdraw 20,000, then we have to call the actual method. How to call actual method? Stub dot withdraw. To the withdraw, we have to pass the withdraw object. Then the amount will get withdrawn. Then to get the balance, same piece of code. Now when you run this program, what will be the balance now?
Seventy.
Run this code. Now the balance will be 70. Got it? Clear, all of you? How to go for SOAP web services using access to?
Yeah.
Right, everyone. Right.
Yeah, Raj, where do we use that UDD? I think.
So to host your web services, to publish your web services.
Okay.
Okay, we should have a memory space to publish them.
Okay.
Okay. So we are doing some of the things like Amazon Web Services. You can create your web service and contact those people to publish.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Next one, we are having the REST web services. Very simple than this. REST web services are much more simpler than this. So let us go with the REST web services. REST stands for Representational State Transfer REST stands for what? Representational state transfer. And when you go for SOAP, it uses SOAP protocol for data communication, but in the case of REST, it uses HTTP protocol for data communication. So you can select REST is web-based, web standard, based architecture. Web standard based architecture. Okay, we give the URL. So how we run servlets and JSP, same way we give that URL for REST web services. That's the reason we say it is web-based standard architecture and uses HTTP protocol for data communication. So in the case of SOAP, it uses SOAP protocol for data communication, but in the case of REST, it uses HTTP protocol for data communication. Okay, we give a HTTP URL to the client. Then, one more advantage of going for REST is, in the case of SOAP web services, the web service is given in which format? XML format, right?
Yes.
Digital file. So we have given in the form of XML format, digital file. But here, we can represent the resource. Resource means your web service. Okay, so we can represent the resource in different formats. That is advantage of going for REST. So REST uses various formats, various representations to represent the resource. Always remember, the resource means your web service. To represent the resource, like plain text, we can represent the resource in plain text. We can represent the resource in HTML format, XML and JSON. What is JSON?
JavaScript object notation.
JavaScript object notation. Okay, so this is similar to your XML only. JSON, this is similar to XML. So instead of XML, some people uses JSON and widely used by .NET people. Okay, so I too don't have idea on JSON. Okay. Now, whenever you want to go for REST web services, we have to know some of the annotations, the JAX RS API. So in this one, we are going to learn some of the annotations. Like @ path annotation. @ path. So if you understand these annotations, that completes our REST web services. @ path annotation, and here we provide the path. We provide the path. Just 1 minute. I'm back again. So @ path, your path. The main use of this path, @ path, the path what we are going to do is, understand carefully, sets the path to base URL plus your path. Means the base URL is based on the application name, the project name, based on the application name, the servlet, and the URL pattern in web.xml file. As a simple example, let us suppose we are having a class, something like, let me say something like product. Something like product. So we're having a class called as product. So in order to access this, so if I want to make this one product as a web service, to access your product web service, what path we have to give to the client is like this. @ path, I'm saying here, slash product. We are saying here what? Slash product. Then, so how to give the URL to the client to access this product class? Because product will become a web service now. Just by using the notation at the rate path, product will become web service. Then, how to give the URL to the client in order to access this product web services? So, you can select client URL to access product web service. So, what URL we give to the client here is nothing like visitor files. So, we give like this. So, it's based on web architecture. So, http://localhost:8080 means we are giving the server details, where server is running, and we give the project name. What is this REST AWS? The project name, the web project name, slash REST. It is the URL pattern given in web.xml file, and we say product. So this is the path, product. This last one is the product. So when we use product, then it will go to this class, because your project may have so many web services. Then how to refer to the particular web service? By using the path annotation. By using path annotation. So in this one, REST AWS is what here? The project name. REST, it is a URL pattern in web.xml file. And product path to access the resource. So here we use the terminology, instead of web service, we call it as a resource. Okay. Right, Jyoti?
Yeah.
Right, Hemabindu, Monica?
Yeah.
Shivam?
Yeah.
Right, Soumya, Swati? Vinila? So you'll understand every bit when we start writing the applications. It's very easy concept. REST web services are very easy. So we create a class. We create a class. Yeah, I'm unable to unmute from my end. Hemabindu and Vinila. Let's just check it from your side also. One second. You can use messages. Right. So you are going to create a class in order to access your resource. So Hemabindu, for me it is showing that it's muted by yourself only. Self. So instead of rejoining, you can use the messages. Okay, Hemabindu. Vinila? Right. So check it in between also. Sometimes it will get unmuted automatically. Now, so we are going to create a class. If you want to make your classes web service, a simple annotation what we have to use, @path, and give the path to access your resource. That's it. That's the final word. Then, next one, we are having @get method, get annotation, @get annotation. So uses HTTP get method. So when from the client, if you are getting the method call as get method, so if you are, when you go for read operation, it uses get method. So by default, HTTP goes for what? Get method. So when the request is get method, then it's going to call the methods under get, like this. Use it for read operations, and you can say specifies method response to get request. Response to get request. Okay. So as a simple example, you can select So we are giving @ path annotation for product. And in product, so in order to enter into the product class, we use the annotation path and we give the URL as path. Then here in this one, we are going with a method. Like we say void add product. Add product. So this add product need to be called based on some annotation. Like we say here @ get. So when the method call is get, then this method will get invoked automatically. Or let me say get product. Instead of add is not read operation. So we'll say get product. So when the method call is get, then automatically this method will get executed. So above the methods, we use the annotation @ get. Then I'm one more called as post. @ post. Uses HTTP post method. So when the method call is post, then it is going to access the methods which are under post annotation. Then specifies method response to post method. Response to post method. I'll go with all examples. Then wearing one more annotation like @ produces. So I said no. REST web services are used to represent the resource in different formats. So for that case, we go for this @ produces. And here we pass media type dot text plane. So when you say text plane, the resource is represented in plain format, simple text format. So we are in different produces here. Like we are having text HTML, if you want to represent the resource in HTML format. If you want to represent the resource in XML format, we say here application underscore XML. If you want to go with the JSON format, we'll say here application underscore JSON. Like this. So @ produces is used to represent the resource. What is the use of this? Used to represent the resource in different formats or representations. Okay, I'll go with all examples on this. Then we're having one more annotation which is widely used. @ form param. @ form param. So the use of this one is represents the parameter of the form. So the main use of this one is used to read HTML form data. So the user will enter the input in HTML form. So to read that HTML form data into your resource, we use @ form param. Right? So these are some of the annotations we are going to use. I'll explain all these annotations by going with examples. And once we see the example programs, we feel very easy of these all annotations. Very important point here. In order to develop REST web services, we have to make use of some library charts. So here, we are going to make use of library chart called as JETC library charts. Library charts are used to develop REST web services. So whenever you want to develop REST web services, you have to make use of JETC library charts. Okay, so I've already copied that library charts into our folder. So Java Online 14 web services, I've already copied the library charts. Okay, so we are having a zip file which I've extracted and we copied it. So these are the jar files which are required for developing REST web services. Okay, I cannot send the jar files through email. I cannot send the jar files in my case. So what I'll do is, I'll send these jar files using send space. Okay, so you'll be getting a mail from Senspace where you can find a link to download this jar files. Got it, everyone?
Yeah, but what is JAX-RS? You mentioned about JAX.
Yeah, yeah, Java API for XML, and it is REST. RS means REST. So the name given for the API is JAX-RS, Java API for XML.
Okay, okay. There is no jar for this. It's just a name.
These are this JAX-RS annotations means these all things are present in this jar files. So in order to make use of all these annotations, in order to use these all annotations, we have to use this Jersey library jars. So the implementation of JAX-RS is done by using Jersey library jars. That's the reason we have to copy these jar files into our workspace.
Okay.
Okay, Shivam. Right?
Yeah.
So I'll be sending in the form of zip format. Understand carefully. I'll be sending these jar files in zip file. I'll send in zip format, which you have to extract it and use it. Don't copy zip file into your project, okay? You have to extract and copy the jar files only. I'll show you how to do that. Okay? So let us go with an application today, a small application, and tomorrow we go with one more application. Okay, you can even use the URL to download. So you can even use this URL to download your Jersey library jars. However, I'll send using Senspace. Now let us go for creating a REST web service. Developing a REST web service using Jersey library jars. So if you are going for new workspace, remember configure Tomcat server. So already we have done this one, right? In our workspace. So if you have not done, configure Tomcat server if you are going with new workspace. The next step is create a dynamic web project. I'm saying REST WS. Okay. And when you are creating the project, make check mark to generate web.xml file. Next one, copy Jersey library jars into REST WS / web content / web inf / lib folder. I said no. When you are having jar files, if you want to give it to the server, means you have to copy it into lib folder. Let me show up to you. So in our project, already we have configured Tomcat server, right? Everyone in this workspace. In this workspace, already we have configured Tomcat server. So if you are going in new workspace, configure Tomcat server first. Create a dynamic web project. I'm giving the name REST WS. Okay. Say next. Next. And remember, generate web.xml file. You have to generate this, we'll generate web.xml file. Say finish. So if you are not making check mark, again recreate the project. Okay. Generate. So don't create web.xml file manually. Through Eclipse, it has to generate it. In this REST WS, under web content, under web inf, we are having lib folder. To this lib folder, we have to copy the Jersey library jars. So what are the jar files I'm sending? Extract it and copy only the dot jar files. These jar files. Copy and paste it into lib folder of web inf. That completes the setup required for REST web services. Here, Jyoti Mabindu, the settings.
Yes.
Right, Monica Shivam?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Soumya Swati?
Can we do it by build path?
No, build path means if you do it with build path, it is at compile time only. It is not used during by the server. If I want to give to server, we have to copy it into lib. If I do the build path, If I go for build path, then we again have to copy into lib two times. Why to do two times setting? Just to go for only lib folder. And already
Okay.
I discussed it when I have discussed this MySQL connector, JDBC connection in servlet.
Yeah.
Right? We have just copied that jar file in lib folder. So when you are working with servlets, just to copy it into lib. If you do build path setting, again I have to copy into lib also because it will search only in lib folder.
Okay.
Dynamic web project means server set. Okay. Now let us go for the next one. Create a class which you want to make it as web service. So for that, create a package com.ws.rest in rest.ws project. Create a class hello, a small program in com.ws.rest. REST package. So this is your resource. Okay. So right click on REST AWS, create a package. com.ws.rest. Then in this package, we are going to create a class which you want to make it as web service. So I'm saying hello. Say finish. In this one, if you want to access this hello resource, we have to use annotation at the rate form. And we say slash hello. So whenever you want to access hello resource, we use at the rate path annotation. So to the client URL, we give the path as hello. So whenever the client uses hello as URL, then it connects to hello class. In this hello class, I'm going with the annotation at the rate get. So for get method, it will call your method automatically. Iterate get public string say plain text hello. I'm using a method public string say plain text hello, and where we are going to return hello Jesse. Hello Jesse. And since I want to go with the plain text, the produces what here? Iterate produces. So what is the representation here? Media type text plain. So when you say text plain, the resource will be represented in plain text, simple plain text. Okay. Then I'll be taking the examples of other representations in tomorrow's class. So today I'm just going with one method at the rate get and produces in which format? Plain text. Then this is your actual method of your resource. Okay, this is the method we want to call. And in order to call this method, since it is get, automatically it will come to this method when the request is of type get method. Let me go for that. Okay. The next step what we need to do is, we are in one very important step here. We have to update your web.xml file. Update web.xml file. Why we should update is, here in this one we are going to provide the URL pattern and in which package the resources are available. So let us open this web.xml file and we have to provide the details of URL pattern and the package details where resources are available. So we need to add some piece of code again. Servlet name, I'm saying Jesse, your wish, anything. Right. Servlet class, here we have to load a class here called as servlet container. So this servlet container comes from Jesse libraries. So we have to refer with the package name. org.glassfish.jersey.servlet.servlet container. This is the package details of servlet container. Okay, no need to remember all these things. Okay. Next one, servlet mapping. Servlet mapping. So in this one we say servlet name jersey and the URL pattern URL pattern. We are giving it as REST slash star. After REST, whatever the URL pattern it may be, this class should get loaded. So once it loads this class, to this class we have to provide the package details where the resources are available. How to provide is by passing the initial parameters. Init param, param name is jetsing.config.server.provider.packages. So we are providing the package details where your resources are available. So in which package the resources are available?
com.info.rust.ws.rust.
So we are just providing the package details to the servlet container where the resources are available, so that it will go to that package and pull out the resources. So that is the need of configuring this web.xml file. Load and startup. So the meaning of load and startup is when you start the server, this class should get loaded automatically. That's it. Now, run your server. Okay, run your application. So right click on server and say run as, run on server. Say finish. Run the application. Right click on REST AWS, run as, run on server. That's it. So your server will get started again. Then it will deploy your resource onto the server. So we won't get any output because there is no welcome page here. So once you run it on the server, now we want to go with the client program. Now you should write the client program. So the client program you can write any way. Any project also you can create. Okay. So you can go with new workspace also. You can even go with new workspace. Okay. So instead of going with new workspace, what I'm doing, I'm just going to create a new project here. You can even go do this one in some other workspace also. I'm just going with a simple new Java project. REST AWS client create a Java project. Let me say this REST AWS client. Okay, and you can create this project anyway. Okay, we can even go with some other location also if connected through network. Okay, so then next step, add the Jetsy libraries to build path of REST AWS client project. Okay, we need to add the Jetsy libraries here also. Okay, how to add it? Build path here. Build path, configure build path. Libraries, add action jars, select your Jetsy library jars. Okay, apply in codes. Clear all of you? Up to you? Right, everyone? What we have done, just created a simple Java project, and what we have done, we have just added the Jetsy libraries to the client project. Okay. Create a client program. Create a test class client. Test class hello client. I'm saying here hello client in REST AWS client. Refer program hello client dot, this is the one which we need to write. New class, I'm saying the name hello client with the main method. Okay, start writing the code. So first step is string URL. What is the URL to access the results? http://localhost:8080. This URL will be given by the provider, web service provider. So that URL I am using there. Then what is the URL asset? REST AWS. REST is the URL pattern, and to access your results, what is the URL? Hello. So when it's referred to hello, it will go to this hello class. Got it? And by default the method call is get, so this method will get executed automatically. So this is the client URL. Got it, everyone? How to give the client URL now to access your results? So this URL we give to the clients, right, everyone? So client is equal to client dot create. Then next we have to say here web resource. Okay, no need to remember. No one will ask all these codes. C dot resource and pass the URL. So the resource method we have to pass the URL. Then client response CR equal to W dot get client response dot class. Then you can say that this is our actual method. String s equal to, by using the web resource object, we have to call the method get. And what is the type of object you are going to return? Class, string class. The written type is what type? Get string. So when you call the method w.get, it goes to this hello.java and calls this get method. So this method will get invoked automatically. So when you call this method, whatever the return value it's going to do, that value will come and store into this S. Then display the value of S. Then if you want to know the status of your resource, then you can say here int I equal to CR dot get status. So whether it has been executed properly or not. Let me run this and explain. Just run this program as a simple Java application. See here, are you getting the output here? Hello JC. From where you are getting? By connecting to REST web service. And we are accessing which resource? Hello. In that resource hello, we are calling the get method. So since we are calling the get method, so what is going to return for us? It will go to this method automatically, and this value will be returned back to us. Okay, that value will be returned back to us. And here we are using some other code. Like I want to know the status. In order to know the status of your application, so we use this method what? Client response. So this is the option for us. Client response. So I want to know the response code. To get that response code, we call the method get status. So if the code is executed properly, if the resource is available, then we get 200. 200 means okay. 200 status code means okay, means your application is executed properly. If you get 404, not found, right? The status code 404 means not found. You can see it. HTTP status 404 means not. Since the resource is executed properly, we got the response as what? 200. 200 indicates the resource is available. Clear? A basic idea of REST web services today. Jyoti Hemabindu?
Yeah.
Right. Monica Shiva?
Yeah.
Soumya Swati?
Yeah.
Vinila? Right? So you have to practice this properly once again. And tomorrow we go with some more examples on this REST web services so that you feel comfortable with REST also. Okay?
Raj, I'm getting errors in SOAP. Can you check it once?
Yeah, I've checked your mail. So, did you follow the steps as it is?
Yeah, I tried a lot for four, five times.
Okay. And even which version you are using, that access tool?
Two.
Access tool, which version? You have downloaded 1.7, no? So just
yeah.
go for this one once, because I did not check that one. So go with this version which I have used yesterday, 1.6.4.
Okay.
Okay, go with this one, and if just follow the steps as given in the document. If you miss out one step,
I create, I got the client one, but when we will get the first top classes, no, it is not representing. They are not working.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So first you check this one. If still you are getting, let us do it tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Check with this 1.6.4.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, so in tomorrow's class, that is the last day of our web services and the last day of our advanced Java. Then from day after tomorrow, we will be starting up with the frameworks. Okay, so thank you all. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. Thank you all.
Thank you.